So it's time to talk athletics on the score this week, and I'm delighted to say joining me to talk about the return and getting back involved in sport again is Dermot McGranaghan, and he of course is Regional Development Officer for the Northwest with Athletics Ireland. Dermot, it's good to see you and good to talk to you again.
Hi Aisin, yeah, good to see you. It's been a while and it's good to get back, you know. Hopefully we'll get the show on the road this time, you know.
Well, literally, you guys are back on track this week. So you are a couple of days in since the return, and very much welcome, Dermot.
Yeah, absolutely. It's been a long time since Christmas, you know. And obviously, we're back now. We started Monday there, so looking good. The feedback from the club so far has been huge. You know, it's been all positive. You know, we're obviously a bit of fear of London would be lost out, and we bit of. Engagement really, but I think looking and listening to everybody, there's been a huge demand for it, and everybody's back and obviously working together, and good engagement over the last 2 days, you know.
Yeah, so then how do you go about organizing and running activities now at the minute this week, because there's a lot of things that you have to implement, isn't that correct, Dermot?
Yeah, absolutely. Things have changed, I would say, and it's going to be changed for a while. I would think I've seen the normal is sort of changed. But, you know, we coaches and all aspects of sport, you know, adapt very quickly. You know, and I think, you know, obviously we have the pods of 15 that we've got to try and work as best we can. You know, obviously everybody's circumstances are different, so the pods is key. But the big question a lot of people are asking, how many pods are we allowed? So that all depends on your circumstances, really. I think it's everybody's case scenario is different. You know, take for instance, you know, you have a big area in Letterkenny, you have a big area at Finn Valley, you know, where like the likes of Finn Valley last night, 300 people. Ross's AC on Monday night, I think, at over 200. Same with Letterkenny, same with Lifford's. But, you know, the big story here possibly would be the likes of Olympian, who are turning a wee bit out of Glen Swilly out there. And, you know, I've just seen a few pictures up there, 10 on the car park. You know, so whatever comes, whatever suits, the big one is obviously the COVID screening, the back and track, the app for the screening more so than anything else, and for the tracing. So that's the new things that's been brought onto it in the COVID questionnaire, so that your circumstances is, you know, as good and health-wise, you know, so.
Yeah, well, certainly the role of a coach has changed somewhat compared to what it was 2 or 3 years ago then, Dermot. There's a lot more involved in it now, and there's a lot more you have to learn about.
Absolutely, yeah. But listen, as I said, people adapt very quickly. The kids understand, you know, the big one obviously is, you know, getting the protocols in place from day one. And I think, you know, with the county board and the new organisation and everything else, we're ahead of the game, you know. And things is the protocols are in place, and there should be no fear whatsoever. We are back on track, and as I say, to reassure parents, to reassure coaches, that clubs are doing their best and has all the protocols in place.
Yeah, really more is pulling together, Dermot. Obviously, yous were organising and implementing virtual challenges and creating different virtual events for right across the county. And the great thing about this was Athletics Ireland and Dublin, seeing what you guys in Donegal were at, and they decided to run it out nationally.
Absolutely, yeah. I'll tell you what, we have a new committee now in Donegal, chaired by Michael Galvin from Letterkenny, doing great work. And the big one is he's keeping the meetings nice and short, which is important, but doing massive work. The likes of Mark Conley, Juvenile Affairs, Patrick Galvin, Senior Competition, Michael Logan doing a massive, massive job at coaching development. As I say, that's not the only ones. A real good, strong committee. Obviously, through my own role as RDO, pushing out, working with Michael, working with the whole team, working with the county board, rolling out challenges throughout the year and even before Christmas. You know, and as you say, Aisin, Athletics Ireland has contacted myself and others to try and get it rolled out throughout the country. So, we had big, massive engagement before Christmas in the cross-country challenge. We had over 5,000 athletes competed in the cross-country challenge. And the new one this year we had done in February there, which was a six-week challenge covering, you know, more or less run, jump and throw sort of thing, you know. And it's been massive as well. And big engagement in Donegal. So, you know, as I say, we're ahead of the game up here. We're leading the rollout here and have no qualms at through all that, actually, I think we're going to have an increase in numbers, you know. A lot of people talk about the decrease in numbers, but I think we're going to we're going to enhance our numbers from it, you know.
Yeah, a lot of sports obviously, Dermot, are concerned about the drop off. And I was chatting to a guy this week who was discussing the age group of from 16 to 18, and that sport and sessions and everything was all organized for them, and all they did, they showed up. So it was very hard for a youngster of that age to do something on their own. So, but you're sort of saying now that with all these youngsters who have been involved in lockdown and have possibly struggled, that they're quite eager to get back again, and you're going to see numbers grow rather than depleted numbers coming back.
Yeah, that's for sure. Like from what I'm seeing, what I'm hearing, especially really what a lot of people don't understand, the coach's role, no matter what sport you're involved in, Ashton, is huge. You know, no matter what sport it is, you know, especially through athletics, the engagement that coaches rolled out and fired out to the parents at home, who the parents had to go within and take their kids for that session or whatever, maybe on the road, maybe in the grass, maybe in the woods or whatever. But they have more or less seen now what we do as coaches. We do it at our clubs, no matter what sport. And, you know, they've seen the positive feedback from their athletes, and we've seen the positive feedback from parents. But the engagement has been huge. And I think that, you know, no matter where we're at here with us, the mental health and the physical health that parents sees that what we have been doing, and they have no problem getting them back in it again. It's amazing the feedback we've been getting from parents, more or less saying, we realise what you have done now, what you have been doing all along. It's been a tough job, but we're so glad to see you back.
Yeah. Funny, I was talking to someone else this week as well. It suggested that athletics now on the return can prove hugely beneficial, not just for athletics, but for those involved in other sports as well, Dermot.
Yes. The big message I would put out, you know, was, is not to be panicking. You know, there's kids has been off for a long time, no matter what sport it is. Natural fitness is always going to be there, but you know, the big thing is, the message I'll try to everybody, all clubs, all sport, no matter what it is, especially athletics, will be the case that, you know, we have no national competition right through to the end of August, or the middle of August, sorry. We have regionals coming through in July, but our county championships and one thing or another is not until, you know, we're going to get 6 or 8 weeks training, so not to be panicking. But yes, for other sports, obviously, no matter what sport you have to play, you have to be able to run. So I would say gradually get your athletes fit, get them back into it nice and easy, get them back relaxed, because the standard of fitness has gone way, way down. So I would say get the fun environment going first again, get your numbers back, and as I say, get it back nice and easy and back on track as easily as possible, you know.
Yeah, and you mentioned as well there about national competitions coming up later in the year, Dermot. Obviously, they are a huge target for those who are very, very committed to athletics and want to do well representing their club and indeed the county too. But we're all hoping that things will be sorted out maybe a wee bit better come that stage. Are you confident that you will have nationals later in the year?
Yeah, well, I know we talked last year about this. Actually, you know, but you know, the big thing is that we have in place this year, obviously it's to do with figures really. If we can get our figures and we hear the magic words of level 3 or level 2, you know, we here in Donegal are more or less set up for, like, one of the initiatives that Mark Conley set up is triangular meets, you know, which we can get, we're allowed to have participation or competition with 200 people, you know, these tri meets is going to be huge locally. County championships then, obviously level 2, we're looking obviously 400 people for those. Obviously regional championships is penciled in for July, and yes, the national championships are on the first 3 weekends for juveniles, are on the first 3 weeks of August, so they are penciled in. Obviously it's to do with this rollout of the vaccines and one thing and another, and that's going to be key, Oisin, you know.
Yeah. Just finally then, Dermot, as you wait these dates and levels to come back in where you can implement your strategy and get competitions back again, and by the way, you're talking about how the Donegal board are working at the moment, is it fair to say then that Donegal are in a very, very solid position going forward when all this action is set to come back?
Yeah, absolutely brilliant. The likes of, you know, I can't say enough about the likes of Michael Logie from Rosses, the coaches forums that he's doing every 2 weeks, you know, bringing on the ground coaches, juvenile coaches, and getting them ahead of the game, having discussion about training, ideas, sharing ideas. Listen, it's not happening anywhere else throughout the country. Through my areas now, I'm trying to do that. You know, then the other ones, club captains, senior club captains, putting a presentation together at the minute, to try and help the senior clubs together. Maybe this rollout of county championship, making it a better environment as far as county level and prestigious to compete. You know, at the end of the GA and you're competing for your county, let's do the same for athletics. And that's what's happening here at the minute. And I have no qualms about it, that our sport is getting stronger and stronger, you know, and that's all down to the people that's working on the ground. Like, at the end of the day, we're all working together. The likes of Patsy there, who's been promoting the sport of athletics for years and years and years. There's so many other people doing it now, and it's great to see, you know.
Yeah. Well, good to talk to you and good to see you as well. And the best of luck and your continued success in developing athletics in the Northwest. And obviously back on the track now. Hopefully we'll get these dates back soon and levels as well to see real serious competition taking place. Thanks, Dermot.
Yeah, absolutely. Just one more action just on the junior element of it, you know, just catching up on that. We find that obviously our juniors and our under 23s and our drop-off is huge importance to us. And those are the athletes that's missed out for the last couple of years, you know, it's coming into that crossroads of college and one thing and another. So what we're trying to do, obviously, with the rollout and one thing and another, we're actually looking for a few exemptions for people who are looking for standards for European competition, because the European youth is on this year. Youth has just been cancelled. The juniors and the under 23s, one's in Estonia and the other one's in Norway. So that's what we're trying to do as well, actually, trying maybe to get a few exemptions so that people can travel to Northern Ireland or to England or whatever for trying to create a standard, you know.
Okay. Thanks, Dermot.
Thanks, Ashin. Thank you.